Does anybody wake up like this in the morning?
Yes.
Yes.
I do.
Does anybody eat like this?
Yes.
Not to go to school.
I do.
Not to go to school?
Yes, to go to school.
Okay. So, I'm going to show you a picture. What is that?
A sloth.
A what?
A sloth.
It's a sloth. It's not me.
I know why you're doing it.
It's not. Yeah, right. It's not me, is it?
Yeah, it's. But
no.
You have a picture of you being a monkey.
Oh, yeah, I do.
And a tiger.
Okay, so we're going to talk about a sloth. So you were right, Tegan. So a sloth moves very slowly.
I know why they do that.
Why do they do that?
They do that so they can
eat dirt. Right, because they have a slow metabolism. Excuse me, just when I'm talking. Just a moment.
And whenever they...
Just a moment, please. Just a moment. They have a slow metabolism, so they move slowly so that they don't use up all their energy too fast. That's what we tell people that. Torn.
It's because they eat leaves.
They eat leaves, that's right. And they don't have a whole lot of energy, a lot of nutrients in that. What were you going to say to you?
I was
going to
say they swim fast so they don't drown.
You think so? I think they drown slowly. Okay, so it's a picture of a sloth. Very good, you guys. Have you ever seen one in real life?
No.
Have you where?
No, you
have.
No,
yeah. Remember at the zoo?
You saw it at the zoo?
I remember.
Okay. All right.
So maybe
you've seen a sloth before. They're kind of cool in one way. They look like a very slow monkey, right? Mm-hmm. Right? And so they spend most of the time... Okay, you have to let me talk now, okay? So they have to spend most... They spend most of the time hanging upside down. I don't think I'd like that, okay? Maybe playing in the trees would be pretty cool. Where do they live? They live in the rainforest
yeah.
in Central America. Okay, in South America, they live down there.
South Pacific
okay,
rainforest.
All right. And so, name a time when you guys move really slow.
When you're tired.
Yeah.
When I wake up in the morning.
Right? Okay, now, when you swim, you swim slowly, but not too slow that you don't sink, right?
Yeah.
Zariah, what are you saying? Tatiana, I'm so sorry. There you go, bless your heart. Give me high five, low five, low five, ha, high five. Oh, you're not going to play me. No, but seriously, I'm proud of you, because that's what I was looking for, Tatiana.
What?
Well, it's like, okay, kids, got to get up and go to school. Well, how about... Hey, you guys got to clean up your room.
Oh, no.
Oh, hey, you got to go do this chore.
Oh.
Would you might move slowly?
Yes.
I don't want to go
to get in bed.
I can't
bed.
Walk.
Wait,
how
get
about,
in bed.
Or getting in bed, right? So how about doing your chores? Have you ever, Tegan, have you ever had something to eat that you just don't like and you eat it very slowly? What's that?
When I'm eating a snack and I don't want it to go bye-bye, I take very little bites of it to where that it lasts longer.
Well, that's a good idea, but...
So you do the opposite of that. You eat it fast.
You eat it slow so what you like to eat lasts longer.
Yeah.
Right. Right, I just did it back up. Teasing. So... Alright, so... God doesn't want us to be like a sloth when it comes to doing what? Our chores? Or work, or obeying Him, or serving Him, we are to do our best for Him. Do you know what? Being good and going to school when it's time to go to school is a good thing. You're doing stuff to do. You don't like school, but it's still something you have to do. It's a responsibility, right? And later you'll figure it out. You'll be graduating from school.
Doing the dishes.
Okay, so whatever you do, whether it's a chore at home or feeding the pigs or... whatever you do, if you need to do it like you're doing it for Jesus. You know that? Whatever, if you have to clean the bathroom or whatever, if something you don't like doing, you do it for Jesus. And what happens is something very special. Listen, kids, please, Corn, look up here. What happens is that people, your family, your friends, will say, "Wow, those kids are so good. They just jump right in and do what they're told. They don't even like what they're doing, but they take it seriously and they're responsible with it. And it glorifies God." Okay. Now, what? Before I finish, do you know of any bugs that work really hard and fast? Ants.
Got it. Snails.
Wait. What world do you live in? Ants, not snails. Ants. Okay, we got the answer. Got the answer. So, ants is what? Okay, but I'm going to talk about ants. Okay. So ants are all right. What do ants do? How do you know ants work fast?
Because they are tiny.
Okay, and do you know how much they can carry?
Yeah, they can carry more than
their own body weight. Okay, they can lift more. They can carry you more than you carry yourself on your back. They can carry their own body weight. Okay, they work hard. Have you ever seen an ant farm?
Yes.
How they work hard?
Yeah.
They build
an
ant
farm. Okay. Right.
It's have you ever kicked an ant? Okay, wait. Have you ever kicked an ant's nest? An ant pound?
Yes, I have.
It's really not a good idea to kick an ant nest. But stop me. I'm trying to talk. Okay. So, what happens when you kick that ant pile?
It all the ants go.
They go all. Well, they go in the air. But then, what do they do when they hit the ground?
They
start working real hard all together to get everything back together. Okay, so, all right? So, God has told, okay, listen. Let me have your attention, please.
Attention.
Okay? All right, so, God told us to study ants. You know that? God told us to study ants. It means to observe what they do. And gain wisdom on how they live. Proverbs 6:6-8, it says, "Go watch the ants, you lazy person." God doesn't want us to be lazy. Watch what they do and be wise. I don't want to be dumb, I want to be wise. I don't want to be foolish, I want to be wise. Wait, you have to let me finish, Torin. It's important. Ants have no commander. They have no leader or ruler. But they store up food in the summer. They gather their supplies and harvest. That's what you know we're talking about. So ants are always busy. This is what God says in His Word. No more talking, I said. Thank you. Okay? So in other words, don't be lazy and slow. Work hard in this life as kids and adults, and you will, guess what? You will please God. You will please God. So just be hardworking, serious about what you do, do it for the Lord, and you will be blessed, and people will see God in you, okay, because of your good attitude, all right? Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, I want to thank you for all the kids. You're such a blessing, and I pray you'll bless them with understanding and encourage them and help them to take seriously what I've shared with them this morning. You don't want them to be slow about their responsibilities, but you want them to be diligent, to work hard, and to do what they're supposed to do, and let that please you and glorify you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you, kids.